Good morning, children. Welcome to 6th standard online class. Hope you are all safe by the grace of God. I do hope that you have prepared for your science exam. Am I right, children? So let us revise the things that will help you to write your exams well. Shall we get into it, children? We know that we have three lessons for our exam. Lesson 1, measurements. Lesson 3, matter around us. Lesson 4, living world of plants. So this is our question pattern. 5, choose the correct answer. 5, fill in the blanks. 5, match the following. 5, true or false. Each carries 5 marks. So totally 20 marks. And you have to answer the short answers. Very short answers and short answers are together asked. So 12 questions will be asked. From that you can select any 10. 10 twos are 20 marks. Detail answer. 3 questions will be given. From the 3 you can select any 2. Each carries 5 marks. So 10 marks. So your total mark is 50. So kindly revise all the 1 marks on your own, children. Okay. Do it. Very simple question answers. So you can do it on your own. Thorough your book exercise. Now let us concentrate on the question answers. In question answers also, when you are preparing for science exam, you have to give preference for the problematic questions. That is, you solving the problems, those questions. We teachers cannot reduce any mark in those questions if you have correctly attended the answer. Do you get me what I say? If you have attended the answers very correctly, you can get a very good, correct full mark for that. Do you understood? So in our first lesson, you know that in our first lesson, we have problems, isn't it? So what is the problem given? The distance between two places is 43.65 kilometer converted into meter and centimeter. We have to convert the given kilometer into centimeter and meter. So let us do the first one. Kilometer, we know that 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter, right? 1000 meter. So what shall we do? Applying this formula, what shall we do? We can apply this here also. In our question, they have given 43.65 kilometer equal to 43.65 into 1000. Am I right? We are converting into meter. So we are also multiplying it with the 1000. So what will be the answer? 43,650 meter. Now it has been converted into meter. Do you understand, children? This is a simple problem. You might have studied in your lower classes. Just refresh your memory. Then, now we have converted it into meter. Now, our duty is to convert into centimeter, the next task. So we know that 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. So 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter. Therefore, 1000 into 1 kilometer can be written as 1000 into 100 centimeter. 1000 into 100 centimeter, that is equal to 1 lakh centimeter. 1 lakh centimeter. Therefore, 1 kilometer equal to 1 lakh centimeter. Therefore, 43.65 kilometer equal to 43,65,000 centimeter. 43,65,000 centimeter. Is it clear, children? Yes. Hope you have understood this problem very well, children. The same lesson, we have the next problem, that is the distance between your school and your house is 2250 meters. Express this distance in kilometer. So we know that in the previous problem only we have seen 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter, isn't it? Therefore, what is given here? It is given in meter, no? So 2250 meter equal to what we have to do? 2250 divided by 1000 means it will become we have to divide this by 1000, right? So when you divide this by 1000, it will become 2.250 kilometer. Do you understand? Simple. There we have converted the bigger unit into smaller unit, so we multiplied. Here we are converting the smaller unit into bigger unit, so we are dividing, isn't it? Am I right? Yes. Do you understand? Hope you so. Here is the next question. While measuring the length of a sharpened pencil, reading scale at one end is 2.0 centimeter and at the other end is 12.1 centimeter. What is the length of the pencil? Length of the pencil equal to. So we have to calculate the length of the pencil. Length of the pencil equal to final end measurement minus starting end measurement. Right? From where it ends, from there when you subtract the initial measurement, you will get the answer. So the final end measurement given here is 12.1 centimeter. It is given there, isn't it? So 12.1 centimeter minus 2.0 centimeter, that gives the answer as what? What's the answer? Yes, 10.1 centimeter. Is it clear, children? Yes. Now coming to the second lesson. In second lesson, the third lesson, that is matter around us lesson. In third lesson, we don't have problematic questions. We have differentiation questions and tabular column questions, isn't it? What are they? One of the differentiation question is differentiate between pure substances and impure substances. Pure substances is made up of only one kind of particles. It's made up of only one kind of particles. It may be element or molecule, okay? And also it may also be compound also sometimes. Then pure substances may be elements or compounds. What about the impure substances? Impure substances is made up of more than one kind of particles. Impure substances may be homogeneous or heterogeneous mixtures. I have explained you what is homogeneous and heterogeneous. Do you remember? Yes, if the particles exist in the same state of matter, then we call it as homogeneous. If it exists in different states of matter, then we call it as heterogeneous. Is it clear, children? Yes, very important question. You have to give importance for this question. Okay, children. So in the same lesson, we have a detailed answer, that is tabular column answer. Distinguish between properties of solid, liquid, gas. Draw suitable diagrams wherever necessary. So first one is solid state. They have definite shape and volume. We know that. Liquids, no definite shape. Liquids attain the shape of the vessel in which they are kept. Gaseous state. Gases have neither definite shape nor a definite volume. Compressible. Like solids are incompressible. Liquids are compressible to certain extent. And gaseous are highly compressible. And a solid state, there is a little space between the particles of the solid, and the particles have, in the case of liquids, the particles have greater space between them, and in the case of gases, the particles space between the particles is the greatest. Among the three, which has the more particle space? Yes, the gaseous particles has more interparticle space. Okay. Similarly, in solid states, the particles attract each other very strongly. Why? Because they are arranged very close to each other. So they have strong force of attraction. In the case of liquid, it is comparatively less than the solid. The force of attraction is less than the solid. And in the case of gases, it is the least. There the particles, interparticle space is greatest, but here the force of attraction is the least for the gases. We understood, children? The next one, particles of solids cannot move freely because of the tight arrangement of the particles. But in the case of liquids, they can move freely. And also in the case of gaseous particles, the particles are in a continuous random motion, always moving in all directions. Okay, so example for solid state is thrown, and liquid is water, and for gaseous is air. This is also simple question. So go read it very carefully, children. So now we have came to the fourth unit, that is the living world of plants. In this lesson, we have two short answers, that is two in the sense, tabular column question, that is differentiation question in this lesson. Compare the taproot and fibrous root system. Taproot system, they have continuous growth of germinal roots, forms a single root. In taproot, what is that? The continuous growth of germinal root forms a single root, that is called as taproot. Okay, the germinal roots, it forms a single root, that is called taproot. And it is in taproot, it is seen in dicotyledonous plant, dicotyledonous plants. Example for taproot is mango and neem. In the case of fibrous root system, cluster of roots arising from the base of the stem. From the base of the stem, a bunch of roots arises from the stem. So that is called fibrous root system. And this fibrous root system is seen in monocotyledonous plants. Monocotyledonous plants, example, paddy and maize. Now the next question, differentiate between terrestrial habitat and aquatic habitat. Terrestrial habitat, it is seen permanently. Terrestrial habitat is a permanent one, and also it can be classified into forest, grassland, desert. Forest, grassland and deserts. And 28% of the habitat is terrestrial. 28%, we know that the earth is 3/4 of the earth is made up of water, isn't it? So 28% of the, approximately 28% of the habitat is terrestrial. Aquatic habitat, what about aquatic habitat? Permanently or occasionally, so it may be permanent, and in some areas the aquatic habitat are occasionally seen. For example, pond and all, it won't be available throughout the year. In some, though, during summer days it will be dried up, right? Yes. So it is permanently or occasionally seen. And this aquatic habitat can be classified into freshwater and marine water. And 70% of the habitat is aquatic. 70% of the habitat is aquatic. So among the habitat available in the earth, 70% is aquatic. Is it clear, children? Hope you have understood thoroughly today's revision. What I have revised is only the differentiation questions and tabular column questions and problematic questions. Okay, the remaining questions you have to revise on your own. They are theoretical questions. You know very well about all these things. But these questions, you have to give more importance, because these questions will fetch you more marks. As I told you, the teacher cannot reduce mark here. If you have attended the answers very correctly, instead of writing the answer pages together, by attending all these problematic questions and differentiation questions, you can easily fetch your mark. Okay, so this is our idea behind our revision. That is, in order to get the full marks, we have revised all the problematic differentiation and tabular column questions. You understood, children? Yes. So prepare thoroughly, and all are advised to write your exam only in unruled paper, children. Unruled paper, very, very important. Keep in mind, you must write only in unruled paper. Am I clear, children? Yes. All the best. Do your exams well. Fetch more marks. Meet you in the next class. Thank you, children. Stay home. Stay safe. Obey your parents. Make your parents to get vaccinated. Thank you.